Dear students, welcome everyone to my class for participating. At this moment, I am to conduct my lesson on English second part, subject on English second paper. Topics of this today, infinitives. Dear students, at this moment, I am to give my identity. My name is Akhtaruzzaman, Assistant English Teacher, Satyantala Cholamankatte High School. And today I am to conduct my lesson on English second part, class 9, topics infinitive, time 30 minutes. Dear students, you must have to follow on the slide. Dear students, what are you observing? On the slide, on the screen, you are observing some following sentences. Tina wants to read. Tina wants to read. Rina does not wish to attend to the exam. I am going to buy some books. The boys are expert to play cricket. We need practice to succeed in life. Dear students, you must have to follow, you must have to notice the following sentences on the board. And you must have to guess that there are some words, there are some colors by one under the classes, under the words having some underline. Dear students, you must have to remember, you must have to understand, you must have to realize why this underline has been given down. Dear students, I want to explanation of these sentences. There are 5 sentences in just previous page. Here important to note that all of the sentences are joined with 2 before verbs present form, that is be1. For instance, to eat, to attend, to buy, to play, and to succeed, etc. are written to express subject's desire. So, when speaker expresses his or her desire to do something, then it is called infinitive. So, dear students, you must have to be attentive on this topic, because what is infinitive? Infinitive is that when a person or a speaker is desire to do something. Dear students, you must have to notice or follow on the topics, and you must have to notice that there are some clauses, that clauses are words, and one under the clauses are words having some underline. I want to repeat that: to eat, to attend, to buy, to play, and to succeed. So each and every verb's present form having 2 preposition. So when infinitive is required, infinitive is defined, then before the present form of verb must have to add 2 preposition. Dear students, you must have to notice another slide. So today's lesson would be conducted on infinitives. So today's lesson would be conducted infinitives. Dear students, after conducting the content, students should be able to learn definition of infinitives, how infinitives may be used as noun, what type of words don't take infinitive to, various uses of infinitives to in a topic, learning outcome, these are the learning outcomes. And during my class or during my lecture, I want to desire to conduct my lesson to understand or to teach the lessons about these topics to the learners. So, my dear students, You must have to notice one important thing on the topics, on the slide or on the board, that is infinitives may be noun like Ziran. Sometimes infinitive may be noun and like Ziran. Sometimes infinitive may be noun like Ziran. Dear students, you must have to notice some important thing, that is to aid is human. I am to give some example that infinitive takes as a noun. Number one, to aid is human. To give, to forgive is divine. Analysis. Here in the question number one, we can see that to aid is a noun. Although it, that is to aid, has been used here before as infinitive. Similarly, in the case of question number two, we see that here to forgive has been applied as noun. Although before it, that is it, to forgive, it was used as infinitive. So it is confirmed that when infinitives might be Ziran, when infinitive might be Ziran, when infinitive might be or maybe noun. Dear students, these are some examples. Dear students, you must have to notice another slide, that is another slide you must have to notice. Dear learners, notice the following sentences. Let him to do. Analysis. Analysis. In the above sentences, before go, verb to, before go, verb to, got, it is an infinitive. Concerned sentences. It mean verb is applied to before any verb, given. Similarly, we can write here some sentences where to has been not set up before verb given. Although these sentences are infinitive concerned sentence. Infinitive concerned sentence. More examples of these types of sentences. You need not go there. He made me do it. He cannot but go. Note, there are some words like let, need, made, can, and so on. Don't receive to after applying them. That is, these words are called bare infinitives. Dear students, there are some words whose words never take infinitive to. These words never take infinitive to. That is, these words only is meant like infinitive, but never take any infinitive to. Some words, whose words never take infinitive to, I am to mention that words. Let, need, make, can, and so on. These words never take any infinitive to. Although these words never take infinitive to, but the meaning or the utterance or the expression of these words meant like infinitive. Dear students, you must have to notice one important thing, that is, dear learners, notice the following sentences. Number one, active. He made me do it. Passive. I was made to do it. Number two, active. He need not do it. Passive. It was not needed to do it. Notable point. But this infinitive to is applied in the case of passive voice. The above sentences are its instance. Dear students, we have discussed, I have discussed for a long time about infinitives, but at this moment you must have to notice there are some important things. When infinitive to is not required or it is not used, when active voice or active form is written down, but when this sentence or this clause is possible to write down as passive form, then infinitive to must be added in the sentences of passive mood, because he made me do it. This is the active form. When this sentence do, when this sentence is needed to transfer or to change into passive mode, then infinitive to must be added. That is, in the select we must have to show it was made to do it. It was made to do it. Active voice. You need not do it. Here do has been added, but no infinitive is applied here. But when you requires, when you require to write down or to say, to turn the sentence into passive mode, then infinitive to must be added. That is, it was not needed to do it. Dear students, you must have to notice another thing, that is, evaluation group or evaluation work. What is evaluation work? Evaluation work, and this is a group work. Write a short paragraph on your school using infinitives to in the sentences. Dear students, you must have to notice some students, they are always trying to write down some sentences or clauses, which clauses take infinitive to. So, I want to give this test to you, and you must have to do this work within few minutes or few times. Dear students, you must have to notice important thing, that is answer of the evaluation. In previous slide I told that you must have to, that is the student must have to write down some sentences or some clauses on your school. In the sentences on your school, you or he or she must have to add some words. Which words take infinitive to? So, dear students, I have given its a solution. I am a student. Dear student, please notice what I have written down. I am a student of class 9. I read in school. The name of my school is X. I have to go to school daily. I have to give my daily lesson to my teachers. I have to follow their school set discipline. If I neglect these rules of my schools, I have to receive penalty. No one can here deny to follow the rules of the institution. So I always try to obey, giving honor to the schools. So my dear student, these are the words. And these words have been written down on a school. And these are the words, in these words have been used infinitive to. So here I have to mention to go, to give, to follow, to receive, to follow, to obey. These are the infinitive. So there is that you must have to put it on an important thing, that is infinitive is that that word before main verb must have to add preposition to. Infinitive is that word before present form of any verb must have to add in preposition to. So my dear students, we have come at the last position of the classes, and I am to give my students some homework. Write at least 5 sentences whose verbs do not accept infinitive to. Whose verbs do not accept infinitive to. So, dear students, how much you have benefited by the lessons, I don't know. But during such type of situation we are passing or we are going, and in this situation, any sorts of academic lessons or any sorts of institutional education have been stopped due to serious virus, namely coronavirus. So, dear students, you must have to be attentive and must have to stay at home and must have to preserve the hygiene of a health. And you must have to be attentive to your studies. Because if you don't be attentive to your studies, you never be succeeded in life. Because in 2020 is such type of year. In this year, all of the academic teaching learning process has been totally stopped. So dear students, so who are the students of talented, who are the students of intelligent, they must have to realize the importance of home reading. Although the teachers or the instructor of institutions are not present to motivate or to teach the learners. So you must have to be attentive and serious and be conscious by own self, and always take participation in your academic lesson. So thank you very much. In my next class, I will conduct with you another topic. Thanks a lot.